Hello everyone, welcome to the Stock Trading Tutor channel. If you'd like to create a free Demat account with Alice Blue, click the link in the description and fill out your details. You'll also get intraday recommendation calls and you can learn robo trading software for free. Now let's wrap up the stock market news for the day. As we can see in the benchmark indices, they ended in red again for the recent consecutive days. BSE Sensex ended 0.26% lower at 37,462 and Nifty ended 0.20% lower with 11,278 points. So the top gainers on Nifty were Z Entertainment, Titan Company, Bharti Airtel, SBI and India Bulls Housing, and the top losers on the Nifty were Tata Steel, HCL Technologies, Yes Bank, IndusInd Bank and IOC. Metal, IT, pharma, energy, FMCG and auto industries witnessed selling pressure while some buying was seen in the banks and infra sectors. Mid-cap and small-cap index ended with marginal gains. And in commodity market news, as of 3:52 p.m. Indian Standard Time, the international Brent crude oil futures are trading at $70.66 per barrel. The US WTI crude oil futures are trading at $61.91 per barrel. The gold prices are at 31,842 rupees per 10 gram, which is 0.23% lower than the previous close. The silver prices are at 37,327 rupees per kilogram, which is 0.19% lower than the previous close. And in currency market news, the Indian rupee is trading at 69.88 rupees to the dollar, which is 0.43% lower than the previous close. And in other stock market news, shares of Reliance Industries gained nearly 2% after the company announced acquisition of the British toy maker Hamleys. PNB Housing Finance rallied 8.66% after the company reported a 51% jump in its consolidated net profit at 379 crore rupees for the fourth quarter ended March 2019. Tata Motors UK sales showed that the Jaguar Land Rover retail sales in April 2019 were 39,185 vehicles, which is down by 13.3% compared to April 2018. A few fourth quarter results were announced. For Venky's Q4, the net profit was down by 41.5% at 30 crore rupees versus 51 crore rupees year on year. The revenue was up 11.8% at 829 crore rupees versus 741.6 crore rupees year on year. Datamatics Global Services Q4 showed a net profit up by 74.1% at 26.4 crore rupees and the revenue was up 30.7% at 307 crore rupees year on year. SBI's fourth quarter results reported a net profit at 838 crore rupees against a loss of 7,718 crore rupees a year ago period. The company's gross non-performing assets was down at 7.53%, while the net non-performing assets was down at 3.01% quarter on quarter. Kajaria Ceramics' fourth quarter results showed net profit at 66 crore rupees and the revenue was up 8.7% at 815 crore rupees. Dilip Buildcon's fourth quarter results showed net profit rise by 1.2% at 219 crore rupees against 217 crore rupees year on year. The revenue was at 2,571 crore rupees versus 2,558 crore rupees year on year. Canara Bank's fourth quarter results showed a net loss at 551 crore rupees against a loss of 4,859 crore rupees year on year. The net interest income was up 17.2% at 3,500 crore rupees versus 2,988 crore rupees year on year. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos on stock market and trading, please subscribe to this channel. If you'd like to create a free Demat account with Alice Blue, click the link in the description and fill out your details. You'll also get intraday recommendation calls and you can learn robo trading software for free.